in Berks County.
Good evening, and welcome to tonight's edition of In Your District, featuring Reading City Council District Number 6, a district I like to call the heart of Reading. It stretches all the way from Robinson Street to the north, through Center Park, the beautiful historic district, downtown, all the way to Spruce Street on the south side, and from the Norfolk Southern Railroad tracks on the east, all the way to the Schuylkill River on the west. And tonight we'll be featuring a portion of that district, specifically the area south of Penn. This is going to be the format of our upcoming In Your District programs. We're going to focus on individuals and organizations and events in different parts of our district. I am Councilperson John Slifko for District 6, and with me tonight I have two special guests, Heather Hanna to my far right, who is the president of the City of Reading Library Board, and Bronwyn Gamble, who's the acting director of the City of Reading Library. And as you might surmise, we're going to focus on one of those institutions in District 6, the Reading City Library, one of our oldest and finest assets here in the city. I want to remind you that this is a call-in program. We welcome home viewers to come in with their comments, both good, bad, indifferent, about the City of Reading, and in particular about the library and its programs that it conducts. And that number, the call-in number, is on your screen, 610-378-0426. So, let's begin. Heather, we're going to talk first about the City of Reading Library. At the very end, we'll get into some other citywide topics that I think will be of interest to you, some announcements. But let's start with the library. Heather, can you give us an overview of the Reading Public Library? How long it's been around, where your branches are, your hours of operation, sort of general information that the public might want to know before we get into a discussion of all the programs and events that the library has been doing.
Sure. The Reading Public Library has been around for a long time. Mm-hmm. The building that we're in now, was it 150 that we celebrated recently?
The Carnegie Building was 100 years old.
100 years
2013.
Old.
2013.
Mm-hmm. And the library itself has been around for much longer than that.
Right, right.
So we've been an institution in the City of Reading for quite a while.
Back into the 1700s, mm-hmm. am I correct?
Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty old. Yeah.
Yeah. But the Reading Public Library is there for everyone, and mm-hmm. it serves the population and its changing needs. Mm-hmm. You know, back in the 1700s, it was a different atmosphere
sure.
than what we have today. Uh-huh. And now we're gearing things more toward technology. Mm-hmm. And we do a lot with ebooks and audiobooks, e-media, mm-hmm. all kinds of things that didn't even exist in the
yeah.
understanding back when the library first started.
Right.
We have four branches. Mm-hmm. We have the main library, which is located at 100 South 5th Street in mm-hmm. downtown Reading. That's at the corner of 5th and Franklin.
Right.
And our hours there are Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, 9:30 to 7, and Thursday and Friday, 9:30 to 5:30, and Saturdays, 9:30 to 3.
Mm-hmm.
Our Northwest branch, that is located at 11th and Pike. is it?
Northeast is 11th.
Oh, Northeast, I'm sorry.
Right.
Northeast is 11th and Pike. Mm-hmm. That's Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. Monday's 9:30 to 5, Wednesday's 12 to 7:30, and Saturday's 10 to 3. Northwest mm-hmm. is located right off of Schuylkill Avenue, off of the bridge, and that library is open Tuesdays from 12 to 7:30, Thursdays 9:30 to 5, and Saturdays 10 to 3. The Southeast branch, which is located on Perkiomen Avenue, mm-hmm. I'm not sure what the cross street is there.
There really isn't one. It's like 1426.
Okay, 1426.
About Chestnut, yeah, mm-hmm. Perkiomen, Chestnut, somewhere around there, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And those hours are Monday, 12 to 7:30, Wednesdays, 9:30 to 5, and Saturdays, 10 to 3. Mm-hmm. So plenty of options to mm-hmm. get out there, but mm-hmm. then there's also the e-library,
right.
which you can take your phone or your tablet and you can go on to our website and you can access the e-media that's available. Books, audio, video. Mm-hmm. It's just all there. I think you can do magazines too.
Mm-hmm. It's right off just, of your phone or your mm-hmm. computer.
Yeah. Wow. I ride the bus home from work
uh-huh.
reading my library book on my phone.
Uh-huh.
It's
uh-huh.
great. It's uh-huh. very relaxing.
Mm-hmm.
So we recently had a fundraiser on mm-hmm. March 18th, mm-hmm. and that was Cocktails and Classics. And I have some pictures I'd like to show
you. Sure, sure. This was at the Abe Lincoln?
It was at the Abe Lincoln, the mm-hmm. historic Abe Lincoln Hotel,
right,
and it
right.
was beautiful.
Which is within our district.
Absolutely.
We have so many neat features in our district. Yeah, that's, yeah.
Here's the jazz band that played. And they were wonderful.
Uh-huh.
Salsa demonstration that was part of our auction as well. Some of the food vendors. Wonderful food that they had available.
Mm-hmm.
Some of our guests who are bidding on items at the silent auction.
Mm-hmm.
That's our board secretary, Stephanie Tulls. She's looking to bid on something there.
Mm-hmm. How many people were came, Heather?
It was over 125.
Mm-hmm.
It was actually
mm-hmm.
closer to 200.
Was it 200?
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
I'm sorry. I'm very bad with numbers,
mm-hmm.
memorizing. Who's doing what?
Mm-hmm.
If we could get back to that screen here. Sorry there that I have to do it manually like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Before. So then we have... We can get off of the screen for the pictures for Cocktails and Classics.
Okay, now it's just us.
Great.
Okay, good.
Then we have some other images. Let me see here.
And how much money did you raise? And
we raised over $65,000,
uh-huh.
which was $5,000 more than what we raised last year.
Mm-hmm.
So
excellent.
It was very good.
Mm-hmm.
And that goes to programming.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, it doesn't go to salaries or operating costs. It goes all toward the programs that we provide.
Something that you can mm-hmm. see.
That's right.
And
something that benefits
good.
Everybody.
That's great.
Yeah.
We had wonderful donations that were given by so many wonderful businesses. Bruno Furs gave, mm-hmm. Riverview Nursery, Max Crema's, I know there was a golf thing that
club?
Was done,
no,
a golf set done that mm-hmm. you could go to play golf and have lunch. And for the life of me, I'm forgetting the name of the club that did it.
Mm-hmm.
I apologize.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was Ledge Rock.
Mm-hmm.
But many people came out and gave wonderful
great.
Wonderful donations
great.
To raise money for this event.
Great.
We have some pictures here of some things that went on in the library, and I'd like Bronwyn to comment on these.
This was part of our first annual Comic-Con, which was last July, and our second annual Comic-Con will be this July. It is Saturday, July 18th. We have all kinds of vendors coming with everything comic books. You can we give away comic books, you can buy merchandise,
uh-huh.
but aside from the vendors who sell their merchandise, everything is free. Cosplay,
It's really a big event. We had almost 300 people last year.
Now, where is that?
Is this
that
is at the main library.
The main library.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
It takes over the entire building.
Oh, wow.
And people came from all over, and we had a great time.
Great.
Obvious, you know, so we have some, we had Spider-Man, and we had Mr. Incredible, and face painting, and caricatures, and comic book artists who actually gave demonstrations about their art.
Now, when is that going to be again?
Saturday, July 18th.
Okay.
At the main library from 11 to 2.
Okay, I'm sure there'll be a lot more advertising.
There will be, yeah. Another thing that Heather was flashing through here.
Yeah, sorry, the slideshow thing. I'm used to using my phone and my tablet, not necessarily
a
laptop.
All right, well, look here. We have our Star Wars. Every Halloween, we have a Halloween bash. Uh-huh. And the Reading Philharmonic donates their orchestra time and puts on a Pops concert for us. And the very last thing we played, I say we because I play in it. See, this is how you get all your friends to help you at the library. We did this theme from Star Wars, and out came these reenactors, Jedi reenactors from Harrisburg called... and they put on a choreographed lightsaber duel, which to music, set to music. It was fabulous, and we had a great time. And then, of course, there were lots of photo ops, you know, with everybody. So we are noisy, and we're very active, and we're really into pop culture.
That's great. So,
which is fun.
So you have that summer event, and you will have the October event.
October event. This was one of our things last summer. We realized that our kids, our inner city kids, really didn't know much about where their food came from. And many parts of Reading is a food desert, they call it. It's like
that's
we
right.
have a book desert. We're also a food desert. The new Reading Farmers Market downtown at 5th and Penn is fabulous. So going with that, we had something called From Farm to Library. And we had a series of
you can show this picture
guests,
on the screen.
Including... the Pennsylvania Dairy Princess, who brought a four-day-old calf. And out in our parking lot, our gated parking lot,
we
had a calf that everybody could meet and touch and find out where their milk
comes. Very good.
So, yeah, so we really do a variety of things.
Great.
Not just for kids, but for adults as well.
Okay. What I know you have a community outreach person who specializes in reaching to the Hispanic community and to the larger community. Can you explain a little bit more about that? I was very impressed with the individual a few months ago when I met with her, and for life of me, I can't remember her name.
Right, Tatiana. Tatiana has moved on to bigger and better things.
Okay.
We now have Daniel Ecuza. He is dynamic. He is an owner of what is now called the Barrio, used to be the Tea Factory. So he has gone out all over the community, really telling our Latino community more about the library, and not just Latino. You know, we have a Vietnamese and a Haitian and many other individuals from all over the world. So he's our point of contact, and he's done a great job.
Next, we have some pictures from the main library.
That's that Carnegie building, built in 1913 and just renovated in 2013.
That's right, and did a very beautiful job inside. You really did.
It's a picture of our computer stations.
Which is highly used. Whenever I come in there, there aren't too many openings at that computer bank, which is... And what do people use the computers for? Job searches?
Job searches, email, just general interest. You know, if you're just
filing your taxes.
Filing your taxes.
I've printed out my plane tickets. There, because my printer wasn't working at home. Went over to the library, printed out my plane tickets.
Great, great resource, great resource.
So some of the other pictures on here.
This is one of our teen Oh, that's our newly renovated children's library with the new mural that was...
Yeah, that mural is just great.
Fabulous. Mike Miller.
Oh, yes, yes.
Mike Miller mural.
Uh-huh.
And those were private funds that were donated to create that mural.
Right, mm-hmm. Right.
This is another
This is a teen art activity.
Mm-hmm.
It's just really great stuff that we
have going on. Do you have anything about your children's programs? I was very impressed with what you do with the children. The after school programs or
mm-hmm. We have something every day
mm-hmm.
at some time between 4 and 4:30
uh-huh.
for the public. Everything is free. We have everything from Wii games and activities to book clubs where kids will put together puzzles or do mm-hmm. something else with their hands while we read aloud.
Mm-hmm.
We have wrestling clubs. We're really big on on worldwide wrestling,
uh-huh,
so WWE.
Uh-huh. It's very popular.
We have an award-winning project. We've actually had Jeff Hardy uh-huh. come to the library because he was so impressed with our world wrestling.
Really?
Yes.
Really?
Great. So that's
is he a wrestler?
World champion wrestler.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
I just want to run through a few more pictures real quick to show our branches.
Mm-hmm.
This is our northeast branch.
At 11th and Pike. Uh-huh. Very good. Very good.
And then next, we'll show the northwest branch.
Mm-hmm.
That's at Schuylkill and Windsor.
Right. That's in my, close to me. Yeah. It's been there a long time.
It has.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then we have our southeast branch.
Right. On Perkiomen and mm-hmm. Chestnut, more or less, yes.
Yeah, uh-huh. A few blocks down from Chestnut.
Yeah, okay. Is it? Yeah.
That's a nice little seating area in there. I uh-huh. think they have senior reading mm-hmm. groups in there,
that
too.
Looks very inviting. It really does.
It is.
Okay.
You'll notice there were murals in each of those.
Uh-huh.
Branches like the northeast mm-hmm. and southeast, they have big murals in the mm-hmm. community room, and mm-hmm. they're just beautiful to look at up close.
Mm-hmm. What are your needs as a library at this point that the community can help with in the way of volunteers, funding?
Always funding.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Always funding, because no matter what we get from government
mm-hmm.
monies.
Mm-hmm.
It's so much less than what we used to get.
Mm-hmm.
And we've cut back and cut back and cut back.
Mm-hmm.
Our hours are cut.
Yes.
Hence the odd hours that we have available
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
at all the branches. Anything that anybody can donate,
mm-hmm.
we are glad to take it. There are donation jars at each branch.
Mm-hmm.
Where if you have a few extra cents in your pocket and you want to stick it in that donation jar, we're happy to take it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, every little bit helps.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're looking to do something a little more substantial,
mm-hmm.
you can always go to our website, and there is a donate button on mm-hmm. our website. Just
mm-hmm.
click it, and you can do your donation online. You don't even need to come in.
Mm-hmm. How about volunteers? Are there any programs that you need specific help with?
We are reorganizing some things with our volunteers
okay.
right now. So
right.
Mm-hmm.
With the new mandated reporter, there are a lot of qualifications.
Oh, yeah.
So we love having volunteers,
right.
but there's more of a process now to get
right.
them on board and actually...
Right.
Because all of our locations have children, so
right,
we have
right.
to follow
have to be,
those.
Have to be careful.
Yeah.
And right. So.
But
okay.
we do love our volunteers.
Yeah. And one thing that impressed me is that, with the limited funding that you have, you really stretch it. And so much of your staff is not full time. You don't get
mm-mm.
benefits. In other words, basically, a lot of your staff is really sacrificing, because for the love of what you do. And I was very impressed at that. You know, you just love reaching out to the whole community, the children, young people, whoever, and believe in libraries. And and just do an excellent amount with the resources that you have. I'm very impressed with
Thank
you.
Thank you.
Really.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to switch gears here just a little bit. We have just a few minutes left. I'd like to talk about a few other citywide issues that are affecting this area south of Penn. And I'd welcome your comments also as Heather, you live south of Penn. You
I
live
do.
Very, very close to the library.
I do.
Yeah, and so this is your home as well as your passion as far as the library goes. But one thing I'd like to mention, we've just talked about volunteers. The city as a whole is always in need of volunteers to serve on the various boards, commissions, and authorities. The city of Reading would not operate without its volunteer base. There are so many, I'll mention a few boards and commissions where there are openings and where we need people to dedicate one evening a week, maybe a couple evenings, one evening a month, or maybe a couple evenings a month to serve the committee. The library board, I think, has an opening according to my list. I'm not really sure. I know the historical and architectural review board has several openings. These are the folks that try to maintain the historical and architectural, the beauty that we have here in Reading. The charter board and the ethics board both have openings. These are very important governmental boards that keep a check on our public officials. The Main Street Board, which is trying to rejuvenate downtown and come up with new designs and new programs to make Penn Street and downtown alive, they have openings. The Planning Commission, there are a number of these boards and commissions that have openings, and we would welcome your participation. So if you are interested, please call City Hall, the City Clerk's Office, or the Mayor's Office, and submit your name. As far as a few other things that are happening south of Penn, I don't know whether you're even aware, but in the last few weeks, a developer has come up with a proposal to develop what's called Barley Square at 2nd and Chestnut. It would be approximately 60 housing units for seniors. 55 and up, I think, is the age. I'm not sure. They have a very good track record in numerous cities throughout the East Coast, and it looks like a very good developer. The one thing that they do is they don't just develop these apartment complexes. They manage them as well. They don't sell them off to another entity. They're hands-on. And so we're excited about that. They still need further federal funding to make the package work. But we're hopeful that at 2nd and Chestnut, right behind the Burks Women in Crisis, that there will be that complex there. Another little development in that area at 2nd and Franklin is the Reading Rising Parkette, right across from RAC there that Henrietta Alban is working on. And I don't know whether you're working on that.
I'm not, but I stay in touch with Henrietta about it.
Right.
And it's just beautiful. They have some lovely plants that have gone in now. It's just so nice to see the progression of that park as it continues to grow and develop. I look forward to seeing
right.
the next steps for
and
it.
That's a gateway to Reading as you come off the Penn Street Bridge and go to the right and to swing in to go to downtown and all the events. That will be a nice little parkette. I want to give a little update. We have a couple visuals here about the UGI meters that have sprouted up all over the city and that are an eyesore. If we could have the first visual here. This is on South 4th Street, which is, again, in our district there. You can see how the meters are close to the street and present a hazard, and as well as being an eyesore. And the city has been fighting this for a number of years and finally decided to take legal action this winter and is bringing a case against UGI for failure to abide by the Pennsylvania Utility Commission regulations, which prohibit outside meters in historic districts, or at least says that inside meters must be considered. And it also has certain safety regulations which would seem to prohibit meters really close to our city streets. So we're engaged in a large legal battle, not only for the benefit of Reading, but for other cities throughout the Commonwealth that are faced with these same regulations. You know, we're a poor city. It's a shame to see us kind of beat up by large corporations doing necessary work, but it could be done in a safer and more way that is more conducive to our environment.
I did contact UGI.
Yes, you
because
did.
I do live in a historic district, and I did contact them through the email that was recommended by the city that they gave, you know, contact about this, mm-hmm. and they said that my block is not up until 2017-2018, mm-hmm. and that I would receive a letter, and that then I should resubmit my letter mm-hmm. requesting inside meters and stuff, and I'm hoping that it works out. You know, the person who I talked to on the phone was very kind and mm-hmm. very supportive with, you know, my concerns and mm-hmm. stuff. So I'm really hoping this is something that can work out without it having to get too ugly, because UGI right. actually does sponsor some programs for us at the library too, which we right. appreciate.
Well, by the time they come to your street, hopefully this issue will be settled. And 'cause we have tried negotiations with UGI for some time and really didn't get anywhere. And finally, what's really needed is a definition of what the law says.
Yeah.
The first round of that was just last week or 10 days ago, and the city did well in that round. We overcame the first hurdle. So that was positive news. And a little follow-up on that, I know our streets have been cut up quite a bit by this operation. There is a repaving schedule in place. Now, again, UGI is about 2 years behind, but the city is leaning on them right now to get those bumpy streets where they have cut into for these meters to get that not just patched, but repaved, milled and repaved. So that just about concludes our program. It goes fast, doesn't it?
It does.
My goodness.
It does.
So I want to thank you all for listening. I hope you've enjoyed this edition of In Your District. We'll see you in 2 months, and have a good evening. Thank you.